this wonderful address, I would like to invite our very special guest, Dr. Archana Bhatacharjee, ma'am, once again. Ma'am, as we have started, its day is looking a little painful for us. But how do you see the whole day towards our youth? How do you see the moment that exactly we are facing at this moment? I was very strong when I was making my script. I was very strong when I just started speaking. But I don't know. I have lost my hope. I don't know. I'm feeling so weak at this moment. But I know your voice, your addresses can inspire us at this moment, ma'am. So I would like to join you at this moment.
Hello.
Yeah,
Shekhar, I'm audible.
Yeah.
See, everything, what I would like to say right here is that long time back, I had a good opportunity of meeting a wonderful human being. She was a lady, a yogi. She was actually, she's no longer here on earth today, but she was a German Swiss lady who, during the Second World War, had suffered from TB. She had suffered from TB. And the doctor had given her up, saying that there's no cure for TB. At the time, she was staying in Switzerland, and she was somewhere up in one of the sanatorium in Switzerland, in the Alps mountain. She was very attached to her father. And when her father came to know from the doctors that there is no cure for her disease, and without telling her, he took her to the sanatorium and left her there. She assumed that her father had left her there for treatment. She'd be cured. She had great hopes in her father. She was very attached to her father. So she did not question why she was left there alone. She was left there alone. The father came back home. After that, there was no communication at all. She was a very young girl at the time, a very beautiful girl. And while conversing with the other patients in that sanatorium, she realized that all the patients in that sanatorium had been left there by their family members to, you know, spend the rest of their life. They were just like counting the days because there was no treatment. The hospital staff were just giving them some kind of support to make things a little easier while they are still alive. Then she realized what her father had done to her. And at that point of time, she decided that she would not, you know, have any kind of any attachment to any external people, situations or anything. She tried to go deep within herself, seeking for some answer. Why? Why has it happened to me? What do I do now? I don't want to die. And she started, there was a library there in that sanatorium. Though she was a young girl, she had no knowledge of spirituality, no philosophical knowledge as such. But still, even at that young age, she started reading the books available in the library. Slowly and slowly, she realized that the power lies within ourselves. We are constantly looking for that power in the external world, but the real power actually lies within us. And in the book which she had written, it is out of print now, but she had gifted me a copy after I had met her many, many years back in an ashram in South India. The title of the book is Wings of Power. Wings of Power. And her name, the writer's name, is Margaret Sorgesman. But Later on, she became a spiritual person. She was initiated by a guru, and she was, of course, given a different name. And she moved to Australia, and she had started the first international yoga school in Australia called the Gita International Yoga School. The first thing she taught me when I had the good fortune of meeting her on the very first day, Archana, learn to mind your mind. See, I'm repeating once again, mind your mind. It is the most powerful tool, more powerful than even all the destructive weapons created by our scientists. The most powerful tool is our mind. How we use it depends on us. And so we need to work on that mind. Nothing can affect us if we make our mind all powerful. So don't be conditioned into thinking that there is something in the external world which is having some kind of negative impact on you and making you think negatively. No, it all, the power lies within you. Nobody can touch that power. You yourself have the access to that power. So think positively, act optimistically. Remember always, behind the clouds, the sun is always shining. Keep yourself so occupied, that there is no space within your mind for any kind of negative thoughts. That is it. Keep yourself busy from morn to dusk. That will keep you young too. So that is all that I have to say. I want everyone to keep themselves positively involved, engrossed in some kind of activity or the other, just so there is no space for negativity, and they should not be victims of negative conditioning. Don't ever permit yourself to be conditioned negatively, because it will go on developing. Over a period of time, you will end up being a very negative person whom everybody will avoid, because you will be sending out only negative vibes. Turn to become a positive transformer. People will automatically be drawn to you. That is the least that we can do. We don't have to spend money. We don't have to spend anything which belongs to us. We just have to learn to make this world more peaceful, more positive, and more beautiful. And that we can do even through technology, and the way we are doing right now. And even amidst all the negativity that's going around us, the least that we can do is to bring a smile on the faces of others who are feeling demoralized, depressed, or whatever. So stay smiling. I like your smile too, by the way. So don't let it disappear from your face. Thank you.
Thank you very much, ma'am. And it's truly, you know, life-changing words. Thank you very much for these all, you know, precious words. Thank you very much, ma'am.